There's no combination of words I could put on the back of a postcard. No song that I could sing, but I can try for your heart. Our dreams, and they are made out of real things, like a shoebox of photographs with sepia tone loving. Love is the answer, at least for most of the questions of my heart, like why are we here and where do we go and knock on us so hard. It's not always easy and sometimes life can be deceiving. I'll
tell you. Hi, I'm Christina and we're in my garden. I'm taking a walk around the garden and I'm going to show you some of how I do my shoots and show you some cob too. So here we are. We're in the shoot greenhouse and I am just getting ready to plant all my, well, I'm in sort of in the middle of planting the shoots for today, and then I'll do a harvest. The first step in planting is to, wash the trays and make sure they're all clean. And then the second step is to fill them all up with soil. You don't need that much soil, but just about an inch or not even an inch in the bottom of a tray. So I do that first before I do anything else, and I line up all the trays ready to plant here. And once that's done, I come to the bowls. These I started already, but there were four bowls of sun and four bowls of pea here that I've started to drain. I drain them here in the sieve, and then I give them a little rinse before I put them in the trays to plant. I go from here to here. Whoops, which is this one. And then just spread them over the top. Quite a bit of seed. They grow really well touching each other. You don't need to worry about them not growing well for shoots when they're quite thickly planted, really. You can see this is really thick. So spread them all out nice and evenly. And then once they're all spread across the soil, I put a little bit more soil over top of them. The sun and the pea get soil spread over top of them. They just seem to like it. I've tried different ways and they seem to like this, so the soil keeps them nice and moist and a little bit dark, and then they push through the soil as they grow. The smaller seeds don't work quite that same way. The purple radish that I use for the soil for the shoot salad mix, I don't cover with the soil. I plant them in trays like just the same way, and then I cover them with the paper towels. So these are just starting to germinate now, and once they are ready to harvest, these ones are ready to harvest now. They're beautiful purple. I just love them. They're my one of my favorites. And so here you can see all the different shoots growing at different stages. The sunflower is on the bottom, the radish on the top, in the middle, and the pea on top. And these were planted yesterday. These were planted a few days ago, so they're just starting to push up through the soil. And these were planted a couple days before those ones, and they're going to be ready to harvest in a couple days. These are ready to harvest today. When I harvest the sunflowers, I use a ceramic scissor like these, because when I was first doing it, I noticed, and other people have the same issue with sunflowers, is they get really brown really easily when the ends of the stems do, when they touch air, I guess. I'm not 100% sure of the science, but anyway, they react to metal scissors, so they react less with the ceramic scissors. So that's just one little thing I've learned after doing these for a while. These are some pea that are ready to harvest today. They'll be harvested with the metal scissors. They don't have the same issue, and the radish will be harvested with my metal scissors too. These pea will be ready to harvest in a couple days. So last year when I was growing a lot of the, when I was really starting to get into growing a lot of pea shoots, I realized that the greenhouse was way too hot for the pea shoots in the summertime. So I would bring them out and the birds and the rodents and everything came out of the forest to eat the pea shoots. So I realized I had to do something to protect all the seeds and trays. And so last January, I think it was January, we built this little screen house, which completely protects all the trays from anything that wants to get at them. So far, so good. And so this is where I grow a lot of the, after the pea shoots start getting a little bit green, I bring them out here and they grow happily out here, staying cool enough, and they don't burn, their little tips don't burn. And I can grow things like arugula shoots, arugula microgreens, all summer long too. And the radish like it out here too. This is my my bean teepee this year. It's sort of one of the things that I love to do is just do some things that remind me that I like to keep being creative in the garden as well as producing. And it's made out of rebar and grapevine, and these are bush beans, purple bush beans, and these are a climbing bean that are climbing up the center, and they're going to be a purpley bean too, but I haven't grown them before, so I'm not sure what they'll be like. But it's nice to see that the beans are almost going to be ready soon. Purple beans and pretty purple flowers too. I actually like using them in flower bouquets too.
A dried allium flower, and they grow from a stalk that comes from here, and they're about this high off the ground. And they have little purple flowers that are on the ends of these, and they're green, of course, when they're growing, and they dry like this. And I love the idea of sort of attaching a string or a wire and painting them all kinds of different colors and hanging them. They're just great decoration. They're great like this naturally, but painted, they're kind of fun too.
This is my little garden house. The ground floor is the garden kitchen, and the top floor is a sleeping loft, a little bedroom. And I use the kitchen for washing and prepping shoots right now, and I also use it, this room, sometimes for some of my flower arranging. It's often used for whoever's staying upstairs as their kitchen, and they can prepare their meals, and I often prepare my lunches in here too. So all the walls are cob, the floor is earthen. So one of the really nice things about cob and building with cob is you can sculpt with it. All of the little niches and shelving areas are sculpted as you build with it. And these windows are locally milled wood, handmade. And then you can also do windows like these, basically circles sculpted in the cob, and any kind of glass that you'd like to fit it in. And it's endless, the possibilities of what you can do with this type of window. So right now, these days, while I use this for some of my shoot operation, I'm keeping my seeds in these bins. So these are all pea seed in these bins, and then I have sunflower seed over there, and all sorts of different seeds in these smaller bins as well. Yeah, it's always better when we're together.
I find the way into my dreams tonight, but I know that they'll be gone when the morning light sings or brings new things. For tomorrow night you see that they'll be gone too.